Episode 42 of the Online Marketing Podcast. This is Taylor Timothy, your host. And today is kind of a little bit different episode. I'm going to have a little fun with this one. But we're going to be talking about online marketing lingo. So let's not waste any more time. Dive right in. First thing we're going to talk about is impressions. So what does an impression mean? You know, we have impressions over on Google paid ads. We have impressions inside of SEO. We have impressions inside of Facebook and Instagram ads. Basically, the impression is someone has seen that ad. So you could have 1,000 people, but you might have 10,000 impressions, meaning these people have seen a ton of your ad over and over and over again. So that's basically how impressions works. One of the key indicators, do I worry about impressions when looking into my ads? I do a little bit, but it's not one of the driving factors of if these ads are performing or not. So impressions, something to look into, but I personally don't really worry about my impressions too much. Second thing is reach. So reach is the number of impressions divided by the person. So the reach is the actual person that has seen the ad. So if you have a reach of 10,000, that means 10,000 people have seen your ad. So impressions and reach kind of go hand in hand. So as far as reach goes, one of the big indicators and factors with reach is going into how many times have these people actually seen your ads. So inside of Facebook, you can go over and hit the drop down. There's a thing called delivery. Once your delivery is up past 4, we talked about that on episode 24. But basically, once your reach, once your delivery is past 4, you probably need to go back to the drawing board and kick out the ads and restart, maybe new offer and different things like that. Third one is quality score. So quality score you're going to find over on your search campaigns inside of Google paid ads. This is one of the big indicators for you if your ads are performing. So quality score, I recommend you have a 6 or higher. A few episodes back, we talked about quality score, but the quality score is going to allow you to see how well your ads are performing against everyone else. So it's going to be a combination of how much you're spending along with your click-through rate. So if you have a high click-through rate and you're spending a lot of money, you might have a higher quality score and ranking higher than everybody else. But if your quality score is lower than a 6, I recommend going back to the drawing board, maybe spending more money, maybe changing out all of the copy. The fourth one is relevant score. You're going to find the relevant score over on Facebook. So over on Facebook, they actually just made a change. So a few episodes back, I talked about this change. But now the relevant score used to be a number, and now it's gone to a completely different system. But as far as the relevant score goes, now I used to say 6 or above, but now with the relevant score, you need to have above or above average. If you're not getting those, again, you might need to change out your targeting, your ads, and different things like that. Next thing is CTR. So CTR does not mean choose the right people. It means click through rate. So the CTR stands for click-through rate, and basically what that's indicating is impressions divided by clicks. So the click-through rate is going to allow you to see how many times people are actually clicking on your ads. So with your click-through rate over on Facebook, I recommend having a 1.5% or higher. The higher the click-through rate, the better. So 1.5% or higher over on Facebook. On Google paid search, I recommend a 6% or higher. And over on YouTube, what I've been seeing on YouTube is a 0.50% on your click-through. So these are some of the big indicators if your ads are performing is your click-through rate. Number 6, we're going to be talking about a USP and a UVP. So these are actually the same thing. Some people look at them a little differently, but USP stands for unique selling proposition. So it's your lead magnet or your offer. And your UVP is your unique value proposition. proposition. So like I said, they're kind of the same thing. But basically the USP and the UVP needs to be solving their problem. It needs to be fixing their issues. Number seven, landing page. So what is a landing page? Basically a landing page, for the most part, what I recommend with your landing page is it's also known as a squeeze page as well. That's where you drive all of your paid traffic. So if you are, your offer goes to that landing page, your other offer goes to that landing page. You don't drive all of your different offers to just one landing page. So your landing page as well, some of the tips and tricks with that, you need to make sure that there's not really any menu bars. The reason why I've found is it forces the person to look at your offer and that's all they're looking at. So make sure every time you're driving traffic to any website, you use landing pages versus just driving them to the homepage. So go make sure you're doing landing pages as well. Eighth thing is conversion or a lead. So some people classify conversion as a page view or different things like that. But from my experience, guys, this is not a conversion or a lead. Guys, a conversion or a lead is somebody filling out a form. If someone fills out a form, gives you their name, email, or phone number, that is an actual conversion or a lead. So make sure you guys sort these things out. This is what your customers want. Customers want leads and sales. Customers don't care about impressions, really. They don't really care about views. They just want to see the actual leads and sales coming in to their business. Number nine, we're going to be talking about ad lingo. So you have your campaign, your ad set, and your ad. So basically, how you look at it is the campaign is the name of what you're trying to do. The ad set is basically where you're going to be targeting and how you're going to be targeting these people. And then your ad is the actual messaging that's targeting your ad set. So make sure you guys have all of these organized. A lot of times what I've seen companies and people do is they'll do a campaign with one ad set and then they'll have like 20 ads inside that ad set with all these different offers. This is a no-no. You need to make sure that you have everything organized properly when you're doing this. And last but not least, number 10, KPI, also known as the key performance indicator. So there's a episode, few episodes back, I talk about KPIs and how KPIs are one of the big factors you need to know for your business. So you need to know how much you can spend on a lead. So if you know that you can spend $10 on a lead, you get that tells you that you get 10 leads and you're closing one of those 10 every time. You need to find out your key performance indicators for online marketing. So I kind of shared some of mine with you guys as far as relevance score goes, your quality score goes. I've talked on a few episodes back about landing pages and what you should be converting at on your landing pages and different things like that. So go find out your KPIs. That's going to help you guys a ton, and it's going to help you have clarity and transparency with your clients. If they understand your KPIs, then they are going to be more happy and satisfied with your business. So that's going to wrap up episode 42, online marketing lingo. If there's some more lingo you guys want to know, feel free to reach out to me. I want to help you guys understand more about online marketing. Thanks guys for listening to episode 42, online marketing lingo, impressions, reach, quality score, relevance score, CTR, USP and UVP, landing page, conversion, lead, and basically your ad lingo with campaign, ad set, ads, and KPIs. So thanks guys for listening. If you guys want to learn more about online marketing, feel free to reach out to me. I am here to help, guys. I say that over and over again, but in all honesty, I want to help you guys grow. I want to help online marketers grow. I want to help businesses grow. I believe if we create a better online marketing presence across the board, online marketing is just going to become easier and better for people. So feel free to reach out to me. Go check out my course on online marketing. I teach you guys everything from start to finish, my entire process. Better yet, I give you guys 3 hours of coaching. So to to fire you guys up with any questions you guys have about the course. I'm here to help. Thanks, guys, for listening to episode 42, and peace.